A mindset is an established set of attitudes and beliefs that we hold. It can be something we don't even realize, but it affects our actions and behaviors. In this video, we're going to explore two types of mindset: fixed mindset and growth mindset, and how they impact us as science communicators. Many of us grow up with a fixed mindset. This is when people believe that their intelligence and their abilities are fixed, that we're born with them and they don't really change. Some people say you're a science person or a natural soccer player. Fixed mindsets affect the way we see ourselves and each other's abilities. Why is having a fixed mindset a problem? When you believe your abilities are inborn, you want to prove that you have those favorable traits rather than try to improve them. We also become afraid to try new things and fail because that would mean that we're not good at them. Because you either have it or you don't. So you tend to avoid new learning experiences because that might challenge your view of yourself. Growth mindset is a different way of looking at our abilities. Science has shown that our brains are incredibly flexible. Our abilities grow if we spend time and effort to improve them. No one would look at an Olympic athlete and think they didn't improve with practice. So why would we think people who are good at science are just born that way? Practice makes progress. We can learn anything we want to learn. Think of something you can do now that you couldn't as a baby. A baby learns to walk by falling. Practice, and especially making mistakes, helps us grow. Anyone can do science if they try.
A couple of years ago, I learned about growth mindset, and that opened up a huge field for me, being able to express curiosity and be able to open up ideas has been one of the biggest benefits of growth mindset for myself.
Using a growth mindset in our speech is a great tool for engaging with girls. When we share our growth in an area, such as using a telescope or learning the night sky, we show that astronomy is accessible to everyone, even beginners.
A growth mindset is so important for all kids, but especially girls, when they think about how they're gonna grow up and do great things. Some of the things I've heard to really encourage the growth mindset is this idea that, you know, I had trouble with this when I was a kid, and it took me a long time to figure this out. Or I've heard other scientists also had the same problem, but they really tried hard and figured out how to make this work.
Using growth mindset language takes practice, but there's two immediate benefits. When some people think of scientists, they think of white men in white coats with crazy hair. This can leave out most of the population: women, girls, people of color, people with disabilities, indigenous and LGBTQ folks, anybody who's been traditionally excluded from science. The second idea is really about trial and error, because that's the heart of the scientific method. But girls are often encouraged to get it right over experimenting and learning. When we share the effort it took us to learn astronomy, we let others know it's okay to fail. And then when girls encounter failure, they can still be courageous and even encouraged. Using growth mindset language may not roll off your tongue at first. It takes practice to change. This makes us better educators, and it models a growth mindset for our visitors. So instead of praising a girl by telling her she's so smart, try praising the process or noticing a skill that she's learned, and be specific.
A little bit of genuine encouragement each step of the way goes a long way, and it doesn't have to be over the top.
As you add a growth mindset to your public engagement tools, be gentle and patient with yourself. There is a learning curve. But here's a good hack. If you find yourself saying, "I'm not good at cooking or art or math," try adding the word "yet" to the end. "I'm not good at cooking yet." This implies that if you took the time and effort, you could improve, as we all can. If you listen, you'll notice fixed and growth mindset language are everywhere. When you hear a fixed mindset statement, practice in your head how you might change that into a growth mindset message instead. You'd be surprised at how much this might even encourage you to become a better astronomer.